All right. Hey YouTube, this is Joe Parma, 123, coming to you with the massive pickups. I had to redo this video because something went wrong when I did it the first time. So I got to re-record it all. There's a lot here. And I'll get right into it. First thing I'm going to show before I get into the pickups is some purchases I did off eBay. One item will not be shown because it's already in the thing that I got it for, which ain't video game related. It's for my RC car. But let me get right into this. What I got here was the original box with the insert. It was missing the joystick and the manual and the little styrofoam piece that went over top the original styrofoam insert. But I had the controller in the manual. That's why I bought the box. And then I got the Hey You Pikachu microphone. I actually have the boxed Hey You Pikachu Pokemon system. And then as I showed in a previous video, the individual Hey You Pikachu, both are missing the little yellow foam little covers. And then it's also missing the little whatchamajiggy, the holder thing. And then I got the slim silver PS2 box. I had the system. Of course, the numbers won't match up, but those numbers actually matched up, which I was happy about. And then it had the manual and everything in it, so it was complete. And then what I did with it actually is, I'll show this off. It was missing the flap here, as you can see, and I actually made one, which actually worked out really, really well. It's actually a really snug fit. And I got a couple other boxes now that I know I did that real well. Now I'm going to do that too. And then this item here, I had to order it for my purple Nintendo 64. Or I should say Grape 64. I needed the expansion bay door. And they, for the price that I paid for it, I got both for like, I think, less than 10 bucks shipped. And if I would just... Because the guy didn't, these are reproductions, the guy didn't have the original doors. Well, there, I only found one original expansion door in the UK, and it would have came out to like 30 bucks by the time it was shipped. I'm like, I'll just pay for a reproduction. It's a little bit thicker than what it's supposed to be. So it does stick up like a centimeter or so above, which I ain't picky, but then I'll just put this up for trade or maybe hang on to it for a black council or something that may need it. You never know. And then I'll get right into my part of the Star Wars pickups that I did. And that, I'm giving these to my cousin Mike's son. Here's a Grievous mask. It comes with those little sword things there, or whatever you want to call them. I'm not sure if they go on the mask or what. But I mean, it's in really good shape. The guy I got it from said a friend of his was going to throw them out. Or something at a store that he worked at, and he picked them up. This one's like really torn up. I don't know if they work, because I had to take the batteries out because they were dead, and I didn't put batteries back in it, which wasn't a big deal there. And then let me move this stuff out of the way here really fast, and we'll get right into the big part of the Star Wars stuff that I got that I know you all will really like, which is... Which is this case here. It's an early collector's case. If I can get it out of the box here. And then set this off to the side. And I know I'm trying to do this video quickly this time around. Basically, you have two trays in here. That are missing some. Like, you basically got little stickers that fell out of other trays and that I gotta figure out, but... Most of them are pretty much all in here, I'd imagine. Besides, there's like extra newer figures like Darth Vader. The one I thought was cool was the R5D4, you know, which his head still moves, which is cool. And so does little R2D2 here. Yep. And then, yeah, his legs moved, and you got basically like the sand people or whatever. Then you got like 3CPO. Then this one was a cool Darth Vader, because I think this is an original one, because, you know, of his cape and everything, but I could be wrong. The only reason I'm thinking he's original is because the holes on the bottom of his feet. Yeah, it'd be original then, because most of these would have sat like on the base and that. So yeah, I was really happy to get those. The case overall is in fairly decent shape. I mean, you got a small, like, this flap was torn, but the other one's fine. And then the button on it still works to hold it together. So, I mean, that's always a good thing on here. All right, there we go. And just snap this down. And then also we got here, this is a second edition. He wanted to keep one of the price guides, which I was fine. They let him keep the newer one. You know, but here's like basically an original second edition price guide from 97. And then you got this I got for my nephew out of the deal. It's basically a 1979 Wookiee storybook. And then there's just like miscellaneous figures in there, like this Chewbacca I was planning on keeping, you know. And then I found, like, here's an original, maybe. Nope, Ellen's is 2001, so I guess maybe he's not an original one, but still really cool. But then you had, like, other odds and ends in there, like, for, I'm guessing some of these are for, like, Harry Potter. Then you got, like, G.I. Joe stuff in here. And then this was kind of cool. And this was in there. It's a Master Yoda. I will be probably throwing it away or parting it out. Like, someone who needs the door off it or something. You know, or maybe, like, the little feet there. You know, but, like, his back of his head's torn open. And that, or maybe it's just he had hair there or something. And then, like, he's missing, like, an eye. And then, like, his mouth was ripped up. And it's nothing too exciting, I guess. I mean, I was really happy to get this little bit that I got. And then there's one other Star Wars item I got that I'll show off. I like to, as I'm doing shit, basically, put stuff back in their boxes. That way it makes it easier to show everything off and stuff when it does come time. And then I got this, which is cool. It's actually complete as far as I know. There's a bunch of stuff still in there that's still attached to the little cardboard sleeves or whatever. But it's the Millennium Falcon 3D puzzle. As you can see, it looks to be in perfect condition. I really do plan to build this just to see it built. So that was good. And then I got, for getting into the gaming stuff here, I got a box Sega Genesis. And it's complete in box. Everything's there, even the game. I don't think the game had a case with it. I'm missing the manual that would go with that game, plus the manual for the system. But overall, the baggies were in it, the cardboard tray, plus the cardboard that went over the tray was in there, which is cool. And then we got here, if I can move these out of the way, basically you got some miscellaneous memory cards. Let's see here. You got a PS2 blue memory card, you got two black PS2 memory cards, the Sega Dreamcast VMU, you got a PlayStation memory card, another PlayStation Mad Catz card, and then you got like two GameCube, a 1X card, and then a 16X. Don't know what's on them or if there's even really any good, but I'll be finding out. Then I got this black box GameCube from them. It's complete. I had to clean it up though. It does not have a manual in the box, sadly, and it's missing the Zelda bonus game and the case. Well, I might have the Zelda game, already, so that works out there. It's just one of the things that I would have to find the case, because I remember a friend had one at one time. And then we'll go over here. I got one box here. There's one box that's miscellaneous cords that belong to the guy that we got here. Let's see here. You got not one, but two original Xboxes. And then you got the 360 Slim, and then you got a PlayStation 2 carry case, which is very cool that I actually got a carry case. And then, before I get into that box, and those two boxes, I'm going to get into these two boxes here, to give you an idea of what the hell's in here. So, I'm going to have to pull some stuff out and all that, so you're going to have to bear with me when I do this too. This is a PS3 charging dock, which these are both broken on this side. As you can see, that I got to re-glue down before I can even attempt to test it. I mean, I could test it on the one side, but I wanted to test both at the same time. Just because it's better to test both outlets at the same time. And then hopefully it does work, because I really needed one of these. So that way I can stop using my cord ones all the time when my batteries run dead, because I don't usually charge two at the same time. Then I got two box games that are in the box. They're both missing manuals, of course. Stinger, that's flap still there, which is kind of cool. Then Deja Vu, which is, these boxes are in pretty good shape for as old as they are. Then I also got this box, which I put my personal copy in. I got a copy from him, but the box is kind of beat up. I had to put tape on those to hold the flaps in, because they were ripping off. And then I had to put an insert in there, but I don't think I have the manual for that game. And then, let's see here, we got a couple Intellivision games here, which we have four of them. And they would happen to be, I'm pretty sure that's Poker Blackjack. Then you got Boxing, then you got Mission X, then you got Star Strike. And then, of course, you know, got a bunch of these cases, stuff. That one just says Super Mario 2 on it. Then here's a Sega game, Sonic & Knuckles, which will probably be going up for trade, because I already got one. It's missing the little flip door on it, which some are. Then you got an Atari 2600 game, Football, which I'm pretty sure I already have. So that'll be going up for trade. And then you got this one, which is, maybe they're in a hole in there. But yeah, see, some of these are all bent up, which I gotta put games in them. Then this was actually a really good find, because you got, not only did you get the manual, but you got the game layout poster, the actual Dragon Warrior poster, and the card thing for Dragon Warrior Adventure Guide. Then you got that thing and the game, which the game most likely will be going up for trade, because I already got the game, but the manuals and stuff will be going with my personal copy, which I do believe is boxed. And then I got Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, which is complete. Then these should be, besides this, that's actually a movie. But you got disc only, for those, which those should be, have manuals in them, even though they're disc only. These are just movies like Monster Truck and Drag Racing, which basically, will stay here. And then you got, this I do believe was a store rental box that they used to display. They took the game out, it's crushed. Over on this section side of the box is where the styrofoam's sitting sideways, and that, which I don't know if there's a manual in there or not. I have yet to determine that, but I'll find out when I do open it up. And then, of course, as I said, this case is complete. This one, but it's all like chewed up. Like, I'll probably just throw it away after I cut the memory card slot out. And then the ATV. And then that's just case only. And then these are actually three sealed games. You got Power Drone on the PS2, Motocross Mania, and then this one's a sealed 360 game, but it's the plastic's off it. I'm going to see if I can't get my local video store to reseal it for me, if they can, because it's still got that on the side of it. That way it lasts a hell of a lot longer, maybe, or something. I don't know. Or maybe I'll get a plastic case to stick it in. Then you got some Game Boy games here. I'm trying to do this as quick as I can. You got Legends of Zelda Seasons. Then you got Donkey Kong. And then you got Ren and Stimpy Adventures. And then you have here Crystalis, which will probably be going up for trade. I think mine's boxed with manual. Then these games would be, you got Pac-Mania, Pac-Man, Dodgeball, Lulu. Then you got James Bond Jr. And then you got Legends of the Diamonds. And then here would be, that'd basically be that game. And Magon. And then you got Nellian's Secret Castle, which is in the store display box. Trying to zoom out here. Trying to do this one-handed sucks. Alright, then you have... These are just case-onlys here, apparently. And this one's for... Solomon's Castle, or Solomon, or whatever. Then you got Top Gun, which is like a case-only. Then you got these case-onlys, you know, for Total Recall. Then you got a Ghost and Goblins. And then this one's for, I can't really read, Rescue the Embassy. And then this one would be Anticipation, Star Force, and Millipede. And then, of course, you got a minty copy of Chicken Run for the Dreamcast, Super Talking Jeopardy, Star Tropics, and then you got Dr. Mario. Then you got here three copies of Mario Duck Hunt, Mario 3, Mario Duck Hunt, Track and Field, and, you know. Then you got here Zelda, then you got Four Court Sports, then you got Castlevania, then you got Tetris Baseball, Infiltrator, California Games, Donkey Kong, Trojan, Wheel of Fortune, Junior Edition, Wheel of Fortune, and that. So, and then I'm doing this quickly as I can, and then these games here should be a case only too. Facing Medal of Honor, Vanguard for the PS2, and then you got a Grand Theft Auto Vice City for the Xbox, and then you got a Ghost Recon 2 for the Xbox, the Hulk for the GameCube, then you got Beowulf for the 360, then you got Ford Racing 3, and then these two right here, which would be Madden 06, and then you got a World War II Combat, which those are... Like, most of these games I don't have that I'll be naming off, but some I do have. So it'll be, like, basically something, I guess, different that I'll be having to look into and all that kind of bullshit or whatever nonsense. So, yeah, let me just throw all this stuff back in here and get this thing figured out. There's that. Because that way when I move my boxes around, as most people know, when you're recording in such a tight space that you got to take every opportunity freaking when you run out of space to do shit till you can catalog it and rearrange it all and that. So yep, let me set these two in here. Then let's see here, set this. Turn it on for a sec. And then I'm trying not to stop this if I can't help it, because it's a pain to try to do this video otherwise. And then you got all these controllers, like a bunch of normal NES controllers here I would have to look at. Then like this one, which is basically an off-brand one, which I have one over there, but it comes out the side. And that, so, yeah, that was something different. Then you have more NES controllers, because I got 6 Nintendos, but yet I gotta figure all this stuff out. And then these, you got like your normal joystick down there, and you got a, like a fight controller just like in the box I showed you guys previously. And this is the main controller I was happy to get, because I've been wanting one of these for a while. It's basically a 4 red button controller joystick thing. And that, so I was really happy to acquire that one. Then I also got this little gem too, because I've never seen a mini joystick for the NES really like this one. And so it's kind of cool. I'm not sure really who makes this one. It doesn't say, but either way, it's still, even though it's probably a knockoff one or maybe even a newer knockoff one, it's still very cool and odd, I guess. But yeah, so I'll get to have fun going through all these things and trying to figure out if all these work or what don't work, so on and so forth, out of this box. So yeah, and then as we move along, we move over to this box, which is Wii. So you got a Wii Cabela's gun here. It's a pump gun. I don't know if it had a clip that went in there or not. Then like it's basically coming apart back there. Then the back butt stock broke off it. Then you got this Wii one where you basically flip this up to run your cord through. Then you flip this one up to make sure it connects. And then I've got basically the controllers with them. I got a red one with the red nunchuck. With the red and Wii condom. Then I got 2 Wiis. I ain't got the cords for him yet. He's got to find those. And the sensor bars. But I got 1 manual with one. I've got a blue Wii remote that came with the rechargeable battery thing. Which as you see there, there's a rechargeable one. And then there's the other rechargeable station. Then a black Wii remote with condom. Which will be going with my black Wii there, which I need the black Wii remote with. That was all stock, didn't have like the rechargeables on it. Then I got a Pelican GameCube controller thingy for the Wii, or maybe it's for GameCube for all I know. I think it's for the Wii. Then you got like another Wii condom, like 2 nunchucks, basically some the Wii wristbands here, if you want to call them that or whatever, which is kind of good. And then I got this cord from a buddy of mine for his studio band, basically like a microphone cord. And then I've got a PS2 wireless dongle for a Kansas City Chiefs controller. Then I got this damn, it's a USB cord, but you'd put your like USB there and this would like literally like sit here. And it looks to be brand new because all that's still on, you know, 3 out of the sides, you know, in a sense. But I don't know what it is. If somebody knows what the hell it goes to, if it's for Xbox or something like that, please tell me. Then here's one of the AV cords that he sent me for the Xbox 360. This basically is missing the red end. It should work fine because there's a yellow and a white one. And then this cord here, which I got, it goes to the computer. And then this end right here is actually the, on a hole, you'll be able to see it, is actually the same end that goes in the Game Boy Color for like a link cable. I don't know if it's for transferring, playing it on a computer or what the hell it's for. If somebody knows on that, I'd greatly appreciate if somebody told me about that. And then here's basically a box with random controllers, like there's 360, you got the original Xbox, Dreamcast, and there's like a red Dreamcast one in there. And then you got like this fake like generic Wii remote system thing. then like wireless GameCube controllers with one adapter, then there's like all underneath this side is like PS2 controllers. Then there's like a fight stick there. There's another one under there, nothing too spectacular. As I said, I really don't need to dig all that out just so you can see it all. As I said, there is a lot. And then here's these games that are sitting on the floor, like the Game Genie, Yoshi's Island, Legend of Zelda, Mortal Kombat 3, Caesar's Palace. And then there's that Wild Snake, and then there's Jurassic Park, and then Zoop, which most of those I already have. So I'll probably do a trade video after I go through all this to let everyone see what's up for trade. Then you got NASCAR 99, Hey You Pikachu, which that'll be going up for trade. Then like a really rough copy of 007. I don't know how well you'll be able to see that. It's actually the same on both sides. The guy I got all this stuff from actually had all this piled up on a shelf in his garage over time. And then there's a game I got from the guy, Despicable Me, for the DS, which is complete. And then in this box here, if I can open it really carefully, we have a Dreamcast, which is, he said it worked, and that it had a disc only inside it when I got it, a slim PS2, on the fat PS2. Then this thing was cool to get this. It's a AV, getting one of those AV things, which is for the Xbox, the PS2, the GameCube, and the Nintendo 64. And then you go like that on the one corner here. And then I think that's where you'd plug it in from. I'm not sure. Or maybe that's just an extra one. You know, and then of course, then I got an NES manual in the lot, which I'll probably hang on to those, because I usually hang on to manuals for systems, because I always get more box systems over time. And that. And hang on, let me set this down here. And then this box here has basically four Nintendos and a Super Nintendo, which I got most of the cords in a box here. This one actually is cracked on the top, which he thinks this one don't work, because as you can see, like that's, see it goes straight when you push it down, and then it goes odd when you do that. And then see how most of them, when you go like this, it has that little click. This one actually, it might just be gummed up or something, but yeah, he said that he couldn't get one of these to work, and I think that's the one out of that box. And then of course, then we'll have to move this box over here for a sec. And then down here in this box you have a purple GameCube with the Game Boy player on the bottom of it. Then you have basically two 360s with hard drives. Then you got this parted 360. Then you got three PlayStations. Then you got two more NESs there, which I should have cords for almost all this stuff except the 360s. I got to use my own cords to test it, because he's still got to find stuff, because he's in the process of moving. But still, for what I traded him, I feel that, you know, I'm happy with what I got. He was happy with what he got and stuff. He's already working on the stuff that he got for me, which is RC car stuff. And that, and then I'll move this box back here for a sec so I can get into this box real quick. And this is just like just a box of cords and all that stuff. Like there's a 64 power cord in there, which I just actually used my last one. And you got like the Xbox 360 AV cords. I actually got the slim Xbox 360 power brick. Then here's this high def 360 forward, and then you get all your randoms and shit in here, like the Dreamcast freaking TV adapter and all that shit like that. So I mean, this will be interesting to see how all this, if all those work out the way I need them to or not. Then getting into this box really quickly here. I don't know how well you'll be able to see all this, but I'll definitely be taking my sweet time to try to go through this box here, because there is a lot in this box yet. And I know how much of a pain it can be to go through some of these boxes. All right, let's see here. Okay. Well, I should probably show you guys these disc onlys that were sitting here before. There's a Need for Speed Underground 2 for the GameCube. This is the game that was actually in the Dreamcast. It's mint as can be. Chef's Love Shack. Then you got SSX Tricky Snowboarding for the GameCube. Diablo 2, which I will probably put up for trade because I actually have a manual, I think, sitting around here for it. Then you got Prison Tycoon. And then these were just all loose ones that he had laying in a bucket full of games. NBA Streets 2. That's PS2. Then you got Need for Speed Underground for the PS2. Then these are Xbox games. Halo. Brother in Arms. Road to Hill 30. Then you got Fight Night Round 3. Then you got, what's this one? Doom. Resurrection Evil. Then you got LA Rush. And that. So those are just like the disc, loose disc onlys that I got to get little sleeves for or something. I got to actually go out and buy probably a pack of those sleeve things just for when I get disc onlys. That way when I give them to people, at least they're somewhat protected. Then I got two computer games here. One was World of Warcraft. 5 disc. That's complete. And then you got Black and White, which is missing them. Oh no, it's got the manual on it. And that's a 5 disc game too. As far as I know, it should be 5 because there's 5 discs there unless it's 6. Then you got a couple GameCube games here. You got Luigi's Mansion. You've got X-Men Legends. Then this one is Medal of Honor, which is 2 disc. It's missing disc 2. Was it, is that 1 or 2? That's disc 1. Okay, so it's missing disc 2, which I have disc only disc 1 and 2. So it actually works out. So if somebody needs disc 1, I will have an extra disc 1 going up for trade then. And then you got this game, which should be disc only. Yep, for Evil Darkness for the GameCube. And stuff, a lot of this stuff is dirty, needs cleaned, etc. I ain't gonna say if they got manuals or don't have manuals, because most of them do, most of them don't. Oddworld Munch Odyssey, this does have a manual, as I'm contradicting myself. And then you got Devil May Cry 2 for the PlayStation 2. Then this one would be ATV Off-Road Fury, which for some reason I got a bunch of copies of that. And then you had Burnout Revenge. Then you got here, which is Fable 3 for the Xbox 360, Prince of Persia. Then for the Wii, you got Smarty Pants. And then you got Mini Golf, which that's a bad case, but it's still better than some of the cases that are here. Then you have all three Mortal Kombats, Need for Speed Most Wanted. That one would be I'll just actually scroll up and let you see them slowly instead of me actually taking the time to name them all, because it'll go a little bit quicker than that then stuff. And then, well, most of them anyways that are actually readable, let me go like this. And then and of course you got the Incredible Hulk, and then this should be like so. Let me see if I can get this to actually sit up right long enough for you to see it. And as I said, there's probably multiple copies of games actually in here. So I couldn't really tell you what's what or what is what isn't. And stuff like, alright, you got here NFL 2K2. And then we have here NBA Live 06. And why do I feel like this is zoomed in? And it still is. And then you got NCAA 06. Then you got Unreal Championship, Simpsons Road Rage, Black, which is a fun game. Then you have Splinter Cell. Then you get, and turn these around real quickly, Midnight Club. Then Full Spectrum Warrior. Then you got Shrek. Then you got NBA Ballers. Not unless here. Let me see if I can't stack these up on the side here. Then grab this stack. And then you got Turok for the PS2, NBA Inside Drive, Battlefield Bad Company, Call of Duty 3, Test Drive, Tigerwood, PGA Tour 04. And so basically 50-50 on everything I got will be going up for sale or keeping, trade type shit. Then you got Buffy the Vampire Slayer, NFL 2K3, Head Coach, Red Dead Redemption, Project Gotham Racing, and that, which I was pretty stoked to get that one. And then let's see here, grab these ones. And this disc only should be a PS2 game, Prince of Persia, for the PS2. And then you got the double pack for Ultimate Alliance and Forza, which one of the discs is missing. I think it's Ultimate Alliance. Or maybe it's Forza. I'm not sure. Then you got American Chopper 2. I'm going to turn this sideways. Fable, Drag Racing, High Heart, Major League Baseball, and Halo. And I'm trying not to make too much noise, but apparently I'm making a lot of noise down here. And that, which I'm not trying to, because people are sleeping. But when you don't want to make noise, you always end up making noise. That's how life goes, I guess. Alright, here. And then let's see here. What's this one? Part of it. Alright, then we got this little batch here. You got Crash. Wrath Catcher, Project Gotham Racing, then you got PGA Tour 03 for Tiger Woods, and you got ESPN 2K5, Forza Motor Racing, and then let's see here. These out at a time. Let's see. Then you got NCAA Football 2003, Streets 2, and then you got Batman, I think it's Batman Begins, maybe. Or no, not Batman Begins, but something along Batman Begins, I'm guessing. And that, and then you got, let's see here, trying to pull three out at a time if I can't help it. Then you got Fight Night Round 2, The Guy Game, Def Jam Fight for New York, which is actually kind of really cool that that one was in there. And then you got these right here. Spartan Cars, Chicken Little, Freestyle, Metal X, Code N, Kids Next Door, Amped, and World Championship Poker 2. And that, which is kind of cool that all those games were actually in there. Because a lot of these ones I actually didn't have, so to actually get them in the slot was actually probably a better deal. And sorry if I'm trying to use the camera as I'm putting stuff back in the box here, because I actually like to do all this at once. But yeah, that should be everything from this pickup video. I'd like to thank everyone for watching my big mega, one of my mega hauls. I don't get these very often, and I stumbled across this one, and the guy's got a shit ton more video game stuff for me. He may have got over on me this time till I get the rest of the stuff from him.
But other than that, I'd really like to thank everyone for watching. Subscribe, comment, like my videos. It's greatly appreciated. I really do appreciate it. And yeah, if you see something or whatever, like in the video, or like local retro, Iowa retro gamers or whatever, you see something that when I do my next video that you want, you're interested in, I'm always glad to do like trades for stuff I don't got. I like even just empty boxes to complete stuff I got. You know, I mean, even if the box is in bad shape, I usually never turn them down just because a good box is a good box, I guess. But all right, well, instead of me rambling on and on, I'm going to put all this shit back and upload this video. So thanks for watching and have a great week. Bye.